It's Bailey here for BBTV. We're over in Bolton for the press conference for Yui Fury and Sam Sexton. Very, very pleased to say I'm joined by Jon Thaxton, former British, European and world champion. Great to see you, mate. Great to see you down here with Sam Sexton.
Yeah, I am. Part of the training team.
Yeah, yeah. Good fight. It's British champion. He won it after, you know, a long, hard struggle.
He won on his third attempt.
So, yeah, his third
attempt. You know, he learned on the way, made a few mistakes, got beat, come back, a better person, a better fighter. And now he's British champion. He's turned up at Bolton as a champion. Mm-hmm. We've got a tough task on our hand. Yui Fury, he's very talented. But we're ready to perform. Mm-hmm. We're ready to go.
Paid his dues, Sam, has it? I mean, you know, when you think of him in that fight with Chisora, them two fights,
yeah,
I say, and then David Price, who was, you know, on a good run of form at the time.
Yeah, he was on the way up, and he
took them fights early, Sam, and he sort of done his apprenticeship, and he wants never scared to get him with anyone. It's proved, you know, that time has been a good factor for him.
I said experience. Them fights were experience. Now everything's paying off. As everyone keeps saying, Indian summer. That's what we're having, and he's done well, but he's learned on the way, and you know, we'll see the best Sam Sexton on Saturday night.
And you work with Graham Everett, your old coach now, you're coaching in the gym and working with Sam. How's he looking in the gym now, you know, as an experienced veteran of the game, if you like?
I've now been both sides of the fence, so I've been in the ring, and now I'm sort of like outside the ring looking in, and I find it a lot more harder being a trainer than actually being a boxer. Fighter, you just you look after yourself as a trainer. And like I say, I'm new to the game, I'm new to this side. And I used to think, you know, you'll be a good fighter, you'll be a good trainer. It's not the case. I've been educated along the way by Graham. He's sort of like mentoring me and helping me and putting me right where I'm going wrong. And you know, obviously he's the boss, but I'm coming along as an okay trainer now.
Yeah,
I'm a decent trainer.
Yeah. 2009 you retired, wasn't it?
I think it was 2008 or 2009, I can't remember. Listen, yeah. Jon Murray, my last fight. I remember thinking, you know what? I remember boxing him thinking, what am I doing in here? What am I doing? This is halfway through the fight, what am I doing in here? I didn't want to be in there. But you know, I had a good career. I, won titles, won the British title on my third attempt, and same as Sam. And to be fair, it's the best day of my life, winning the British title, being champion of Great Britain. Brilliant.
Yeah, yeah. And you challenged, like you said, it was your third attempt. I mean, you've been in with everyone. If I'd not looked back on your record, I didn't know you was going to be here. But, when obviously Ricky Hatton, the big fight you went in with Ricky in the early days.
Year 2000, 18 years ago.
Yeah.
Box Ricky Hatton. I always tell people always say, what was the best fight of your career? I say Ricky Hatton. I said, I loved it. Wasn't my best performance, but it was my best fight. I loved being in that fight. 12 rounds, we had a war. Best man won, but I tell you what, I pushed him to the wire. We were both cut, you know.
Bloody
and
war.
We had an absolute war. And people, it's funny, people still come up to me now and talk to me about that fight. 18 years later, you know, people still come up and say, what about the Hatton fight? You know, and you know, I feel very proud and privileged, you know, that I shared a ring with him, you know, the best man won, and people still remember it.
Did you know at that point that Ricky was going to go on to do what he did?
Yes, definitely. You know, he had a bad cut in the first round. I thought I'd won the lottery, you know. But he went on, and even if I'd have beaten him on a cut, you know, what wouldn't have been a great, great, great win. I know we'd had a rematch and he'd have beat me that year, but just put the record straight. He's a class fighter throughout his career, from early on, right the way through.
Mm-hmm. Because you won that, I said world champion, it's a WBF.
I won a WBF title, you know. I won it. It may do at the time, but you know, being champion of Britain, that was what I was proud of. Yeah. Being champion of Europe, second attempt, got beat by Romanov, then I beat Juan Carlos Diaz Melro, whatever, for the title about 6 months to the day later.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you had so ruining that Lonsdale belt was a real highlight.
That was the highlight of my career.
Yeah.
Beating Lee Meagher, on points, that was my best performance. Best performance, and going in there as a big underdog, everyone ripped me off. But as I told everyone, one thing in life you can't buy is experience. Ole Meagher had the talent, the youth, but I had the experience, and that's what got me through. And I boxed a perfect fight that night.
You've been in with, like we said, Hatton there, some big names, and the European stage as well, some of the top fighters of the day, and you know, through the, it was, what was the toughest fight you had, John?
We've been talking about this on the way up here and all today. Eamon McGee. I want to beat him with forehands. His trainer's here today, and we were speaking about it, and he told me I was the only fighter he ever trained for. Everyone else, he didn't bother training. He was just a very naturally great fighter. But for some reason, he decided to train for me. Well, it's a bit unlucky for me, but there you go. I want to beat him with forehands.
He used to have a cig, didn't he, before fights outside. He's renowned for that. Eamon McGee, he'd have a cig outside.
Yeah, so, or a pint, whatever, and then go and box.
For you for a bit.
Yeah. Typical, innit? But there you go.
Yeah, no, well, it's great to see. I mean, this is a good fight as well, isn't it? A British title fight, like we said.
Yeah, we're really up
for
this.
You and Sam, I know Sam is really, really up for it, and your camp of...
We've done everything possible. No stone left unturned, and we're very confident on the outcome.
Well, I don't even retain that title. Yeah. Well, I wish your team the very best of luck.
Thanks very much.
To see you over here, John. It'd be great to catch up with you again and have a trip down memory lane, maybe. I said to Graham about coming up to the gym. So
yeah, it'd be good to see you.
Down to the gym, should I say? Yeah.
Yeah.
But we'll be good to see you in the future. God bless you. I'll see you again, sir.
Thanks very much. Thanks, John.